How many people are on there? 20 million. Holy shit. There's millions of people here. There's 11. 45. 85.
Oh.
192. Fuck me. Hey, guys.
38 of my life the other morning. All up.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's pretty. That's actually not bad. Think about a room of 38 people. You've done live before, really?
No.
Damn. Hey, guys. As promised, we're here. Me and M Phases.
G'day.
This is the studio that we've been working at. Okay, so it turns out I can't switch the camera, otherwise the shit bugs out. But we're here. We're in this studio. I'm going to take you through to where... Is my Wi-Fi fine? My Wi-Fi's fine. It's the quickest Wi-Fi in Sydney we're in here right now, so don't you fucking be worried about that.
So aggressive.
Everyone's saying, fix your Wi-Fi. Why don't you check on your phone to see if it looks alright? Can you do that for me?
Wait,
what's
your live?
Yeah. Alright, I'm going to show you around. That's where Mark sits. This is my little cave. Record a little bit of, you know, vlogging. Look. GP. Okay. The Wi-Fi seems fine now. But yeah, this is basically where I've been living the past couple months. Getting this shit finished. And I'm going to play you some stuff. We're going to play you a bit of that. We've got the session open now so we can deconstruct a little bit and show you some of the stems. But yeah, I'm pretty hyped on this. I think it's going to be a great one live, especially for the show, the Enmore. If you're coming, if you live in Sydney, I'm so hyped for this because obviously around Splendid it was very depressing to have that shit cancelled. So this one's going to be a lot of fun because You Against Yourself, it's a song that was made to be played live. So
can you break down how it was made, who it was made with?
Yeah, all right. I'm going to put the thing up here to here.
That's right.
And we've just been working on it, getting the finishing touches on it. Just got it mixed and mastered a few days ago, so it's sounding sweet. But yeah, we're just going to kind of break it down and show you a little bit of it. What do you reckon we start with? Going to go with the...
So the version that I have is not the final version because... All right, let's go through the drums.
There's been a lot of iterations of these. And
so,
a good drum test is also if you're in the room, just start jumping if it's easy to jump to.
So these are the drums I added. That's for the verse, and then there's a few layers in here from Sammy's original drum.
Most of it. So it was a pretty quick turnaround, which is easier for me. Play a little bit of the chorus, I guess.
Chorus drums.
I don't know, it's tough, but I haven't heard any solo.
That snare sounds too loud. Why does it sound like that?
Maybe like add in
bah!
Some
bah!
Keep playing and then add in some of the guitars.
Okay,
and then,
like adding some of the okay.
Charlie said, "Someone sounds like someone smashed the heck out of the drum."
Of course you smash the heck out of the drums. If you don't smash the heck out of the drums... You don't smash
the heck out of the drums. You are a soft...
Soft human being.
Soft human being.
Soft and sensitive.
And we're here in the Sony Studios and we can't be soft human beings.
I feel like we didn't smash them enough.
Yeah, exactly. I'm gonna smash
them. But yeah, they're a little smashed. We definitely want to, like, a lot of excitement.
Yeah.
Some of the cool little effects that creep in.
That's a shimmering. I'm going to try the vocals in there as well and see kind of how it all kind of comes together. What you want, I can't even tell. So, like, the chorus is, like, all in falsetto, so I had to add a whole kind of backing vocals to beef it up. Girl, don't you sick of me? Very falsetto-y song.
Lots of parts in the song. We're up to 100... Well, I got 128 parts.
Well, it's also... Yeah, lots of layers, but it's not a very long song as well, which is different for me. It's, like, only...
Well, long is that. Layers is that.
Yeah, I was saying, but like, lots of layers.
It's dense.
Not much length. She's thick. That's better. The song's thick.
This is appropriate. It's live. So, you know, there's lots going on. It kind of all creates like a big wall of sound in the chorus.
Yeah.
Everything kind of like creates one big moment, you know?
Exactly. Do you know, can you go to the top note? Oh, I wish I had you. That's where I put all the other stuff. What you gonna get? Yeah. But yeah.
Talk.
I hope you guys.
You've been.
I hope you guys are excited for this. We're on like 5,000 pre-saves, which is pretty sick.
Woo!
Why don't we bump it up to 10?
Make it a
10,000. Yeah, might as well double it. I mean, you know, round it up. So yeah, if you can do that, then maybe I'll give you something special. Maybe I'll give it a little bit earlier. Maybe I'll do some fun things at the show. I will do anything. No, I'll do something if you get that shit up to 10,000, because I think that would be pretty cool, because I want it to be, you know, I want it to drop well. You know what I mean? Okay, is this all you're giving us today, sir? No, I'm going to play some other shit. That's just, I wanted to break down, like, the main tamale.
What else do you want to play? Do you want to search some shit of... Someone Else's Problem?
That's another song that I teased on the talk a few months ago. But that's one that we just finished as well.
We've not finished it.
Well, almost. Basically. Not mixed them,
see, this is the problem. Rule thinks that songs just get made like that. And he can just be like, yeah, no, it's finished.
Done.
It's like, it's not finished. I gotta slave away for another.
He's gonna EQ weeks. That last hi hat and spend five weeks EQing a fucking hi hat.
Hey man, it's important.
It is important.
Hi hats are important.
It's extremely important.
No, they're all, it's definitely close, but I still have quite a bit of work to do on it.
Yeah.
There's lots of detail work with production.
Yeah, exactly.
But we're all pretty happy with it. And as soon as it opens up, we can play it.
Yeah, we can play a bit of that. We can also play a bit of
Jeff's. This is one that has gone through like a lot of different revisions and changes. And...
Yeah, yeah.
Do you want to tell them who we wrote
this? Yeah, we wrote this with John Hill?
John Levine. Different John.
John Levine. Different John. John and Casey. I remember some good first names, but we wrote this one in LA as well on the last trip. Kind of had like a 4 or 5 seconds sort of vibe in mind, and I don't know, I haven't written like a fuck you song yet, like a I'm out of here, fuck you, so that was kind of fun, because I haven't really done anything like that lyrically, but this is this track.
It's scary letting go. I know. It's hard to be alone. But I know I'll find a way to cope.
bit of that one. A little bit. I'm not going to give you too much, you know.
Drums are slammed on that one too.
Yeah. We've got to smash the heck out of it. Someone just said, OMG, the singer always...
To management.
Yeah.
The comedy.
Yeah, get off the Instagram. Right, you want some, do some emails. Type some fucking... Make some money. Go on. Yeah, that's that one. Play like... What? We don't play Japanese whiskey because I've heard that as well. I played that live on the last tour. It might be a bit of a bitch to find. We don't need to find the stems. We can just play a bit of that. Because I've only heard the live version.
Okay. Cool.
I don't know where the fuck that is.
Yeah.
I've got it on my phone.
What happened here?
Yeah, this one is probably the first one that we just wrote with PJ here. In this exact room, actually. I wrote this.
Wasted up drinking the Japanese whiskey that your father brought home from Tokyo. You said that I can't go home till it's empty, but my lips are dry. I don't like the taste, but I like how it sounds, so I stay there and wasted our time. I try to act like I hold you the colder it feels.
Yeah, then we'll play it. We can play a bit more. We'll play till the drums come in. Play till the drums come in.
Things that ain't really real.
Yeah, you have to go on Ticker Tech and shit, but you don't have to
just drive down.
Yeah, unless you went to Splendor, because then you can. I'm pretty sure you can just rock up with that. I think you actually have to go on the Ticker Tech app. But anyway, basically free. But come down if you want to. It'd be a good time. Yeah, that's kind of it. That's kind of all I really wanted to tease. I can't give too much away, otherwise it's. Jesus Christ. and I'm playing in Jakarta soon, in a couple months. So. Gonna be going to Asia again, which I'm really hyped about. I'm coming to Thailand this year as well. Can't tell you the exact date, but I'm gonna be traveling very soon again. Once we get this puppy finished, and then I'm just gonna go all around and, you know, see everyone before it drops, and then come out, and then I'll start, you know, touring it next year. So that's the plan right now, and that's really all I can give you because, you know, things are coming together. But anyway. Thank you guys for coming and listening. I will see you all very soon. I hope you guys like what you heard, and
goodbye.